Hi everyone, Alina from Xactimate Mastery here. Today we're going to be talking about the carpet waste tool. So there's a way to actually roll out the carpet in Sketch. Rather than just adding 10 or 15% waste, depending on the room size, you can actually roll it out. And here comes Emmy to say hello. Hello, Emmy. Hello. And so me and Emmy today are going to be talking about the carpet waste tool and how you can actually figure out the waste here in Sketch. Let's go take a look at how we can do this. So the old way of adding carpet is we'd go in here to estimate items, we'd pull up the category and selector code for the average grade carpet, and then you'd have remove and replace that were placed in the same line item. So we'd have to go back and have removal separate from replacement due to the fact that the replacement is only going to have the waste on it, not the removal. The removal is the actual of the room, and then we would have to add waste on replacement only. So we'd have to take care of that. And in the calculator field, you might have placed 10%, maybe 15%, or 20%, depending on how cut up the room was, whether there was different, you know, L-shaped rooms or what have you. So this is kind of the old way of doing things here. And we need, of course, two separate line items so we can have our waste just on the replacement. I'm going to delete those off. That's really the old way of doing things. And I believe most carriers, insurance carriers, are using the rollout method for carpet waste. So this should hopefully help you match your estimate to the adjusters. There are some variables that happen that sometimes a complete match won't happen, but we'll talk about that here in just a second. So first thing we want to do is have up our search window here over on the left. I usually work like this. I usually have all the windows closed and I have a nice big real estate area here on my palette for sketching. But whenever I need to use the carpet waste tool, I need to Control Shift R to bring up all of those windows in one fell swoop. So Control Shift R is a shortcut for that. Use that all the time if I need to bring up my search here in Sketch. So step one for this, guys, what we're gonna do is search for carpet. Just gonna grab the average grade carpet. It's gonna load the carpet to my cursor. As you can see, I've got the crosshairs with the little green square there. That means the carpet's loaded to my cursor. You can hover over the living room and left click once to place that carpet. You can see down here below my sketch on my item list that I've got the carpet added. And the line items are in purple because they've been added in Sketch. So if we go back over to estimate items, they're still in purple. That indicates that those line items have been added in Sketch, just so you can see with your eye where they came from, where they originated. Now, one little tip here, sometimes the carpet likes to hang out on your cursor, and if you accidentally click, you might delete off your carpet. It's kind of dangerous to have this just loaded to your cursor like that, so I do recommend hitting the escape key to go ahead and clear that carpet off of your cursor, which just removes that line item from being placed anywhere else. Of course, our living room still has the carpet in it. One other note, if you click outside of the room or click into a different room, your line items go away. So don't be worried that they're disappearing. You just need to click back into the room where you added them, and then you will see your line item list down below. Okay, so step one was add the carpet. Second step, we're going to go down here to view in the bottom right corner, excuse me, of the sketch, and we're going to go to flooring overlay. And of course, there is a shortcut there, Control Shift O. I just go here and click. I'm probably being lazy, not remembering all of the shortcuts, but that's not one I use too often. You can write that down if you want to, but the shortcut would be Control Shift O for this. We're going to click there. That's going to add the flooring overlay, so it shows your flooring cuts. Okay, so we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cuts here that it's going to make, and it looks really messy and crazy. So step two, of course, was to turn on our flooring overlay, okay? So just to clarify. Step three is going to be to show flooring waste cuts or show flooring cuts window. Again, I've been used to clicking on this for years, so I don't know the shortcut, but I guess it's Shift Q. Very strange, but awesome to know that. We can click on this little icon down here, and it's going to bring up the actual waste calculation for each piece in that room. It's showing you exactly what it's doing to calculate, and it's come up with a 20.54% waste percentage. So let's go ahead and try to manipulate this a little bit more easily. You'll see at the bottom of the screen manually placed cuts. I normally don't touch that unless I'm trying to really match the adjuster's estimate. Where I would go is going to be step four. Okay, so step one, add your carpet. Step two, show your flooring overlay. Step three, take a look at your flooring cut window. Step four is going to be your flooring orientation tool, and you'll find that above your sketch on your toolbar. Looks like a roll of carpet rolling out. I can left click once on my flooring orientation, hover near a different wall, because as you can see, we're running west to east with this arrow. It's telling you which way it's rolled out the carpet, literally in the room. So if I hover near the north wall, left click once, you've got some other cuts that'll come up here. Still looks pretty messy. You can check your show your flooring cuts again to see waste percentage. It still doesn't seem all that reasonable. Still looks a little crazy. Let's try rolling from east to west. Ah, there we get two cuts. Let's take a look at the waste now. The waste is higher, which is interesting, but I don't see a flooring person putting in five cuts here. It seems more reasonable to roll it out this way, so you just have one seam down the middle of the room. So that's interesting. We can still keep moving around the room to see if we can get any different ways of doing it, and it kind of looks like they're all messy except for that east to west direction. So very interesting there. It also raised the waste percentage because we're using these parts of the rolls. You can see in the gray, that's all waste. So very interesting experiment here to take a look at that. In review here, step one is to go and find your carpet and add that to your room. Step two is to show the flooring overlay. I use the view option, the view menu over here, to show that flooring overlay. Step three is to check the flooring cut, see where you're at on your waist. Take a look at, you know, does it look reasonable? What's it looking like there in the window? Close that. That's step three, is to show flooring cuts. Step four is your flooring orientation tool. Of course, you can move around the room here to change the direction in which the carpet lays and take a look to see what is reasonable. It is kind of hard to match the adjuster's waste percentage exactly because Xactimate is a rounding program that's doing rounding with the waste in the background, but you should be able to get pretty close if you go ahead and move around the room. You're trying to match the quantity usually on the adjuster's report, as it doesn't show the waste usually on a printed PDF if they're using a standard final draft with or without depreciation type report. So just try to get the quantity close, and that's using that flooring orientation tool that you can do that. You can also do this with the vinyl just to kind of drive this home. I'm going to find vinyl here. Average vinyl, we want to have the roll out vinyl, right? The vinyl sheet goods. We don't want the vinyl tile because there's not much waste on vinyl tile. Plus, it's already worked into the back end of the program. It's the sheet goods that we want to look at here. So grab that vinyl, drop it into our dining room here. It's also going to roll it out into my pantry because I have it set as a sub room here in my sketch. You can see the vinyl has shown up. I'm going to hit escape to clear that vinyl from my cursor, and you can see the vinyl laying out there. I can then, of course, I can skip step two because I can already see my flooring cuts. Go to step three and look at my window, and I can go to that window there and then choose the FCVAV. So you do have to switch the type of flooring you're using here. And then we can see in our dining room and pantry what it's coming out to. Using that flooring orientation tool, we could then move this around and take a look at what would be more reasonable in the room. And I think you've got it from there. So those are the steps on how to use the carpet and actually the flooring waste tool, because we can do it with the vinyl as well. Comment below if this waste tool is something that you use all the time, or if this is new information to you. I'd like to know what you guys are encountering out there in the field. If you like this video, please be sure to press the like button. It's like gold in the YouTube world for you to like my video, so I'd appreciate it if you hit the like button, and then also subscribe for our weekly updates. I come out with a new video every Tuesday. Hope you guys are having a really great week in your business, and we'll see you next week. For more information on Xactimate Mastery, what we do here, visit www.xactimatemastery.com, and we'll see you next week.